Good morning, guys. We're gonna be going to the spot where my iPad was confiscated. Except the standard stuff is still there, and what I had it set up with. Not gonna drive my truck there this time. I drove this car to Idabelle yesterday, which is about 30 miles, and we still have no engine light. So that shows you that the master reset worked. So we're about maybe 3 miles away from where I got it confiscated at. I mean, it's like right by where the dude lives, but I'm not going to show you his house because that wouldn't be a good idea. But anyways, yeah, they still haven't got online with it because it hasn't notified me on my iPhone or my laptop. So I'm still waiting for that. I don't really want to get the laws involved right now. Out of prison, so I'm not gonna go to his house and try and get my iPad back. I thought about messaging his old lady and telling her to have him bring it back to me or give it to her and she can return it back to me, but I don't know how that's gonna go. That's what I'm probably gonna have to do. Or when they hook it up to the internet and it notifies me, then I'll message her and then go over there and get it. This is stupid though. I was just trying to make a YouTube video and I get my crap stolen. Sucks. But it does give me the opportunity to make more YouTube videos. Okay, I'm gonna resume the video back when I get on the road to where we're going. I got my iPad stolen because I don't want to run into a highway patrol and I mean video. Okay, we're back on the road. This is Herndon Road. It's where I do most of my truck videos, like if I'm going to burn out or... Well, this is one of the roads where I burn out at. But I didn't burn out. I wasn't doing a burnout when this happened. I was just doing a little bitty takeoff. I wasn't even full throttle on it. I just had it in one, like standard mode, and I was just kind of easing because it like makes a real nice sound. And as I was doing that, got my shit stolen, so I didn't even get to get the video to put up for you guys. But what I'm hoping he did when he took my iPad, I'm hoping he cut the video off and then just took it. So if I do get it back, I'll have the video of him taking it. And what it'll probably look like is when I did my takeoff, and then you can hear me turn around, and then you can see my iPad being took. But I better quit talking about it, because the more I talk about it, the more pissed off I get. It's bullshit. And we're almost there. I'm gonna get out and look around, see if there is any. Because I used some sockets and stuff to hold it up, or ratchets. I'm gonna see if they're still there, laying on the ground. Pretty sure he took those too, because they're tools. I didn't see nothing laying on the ground when I passed by. Maybe he'll be out there. Maybe I could ask him if he has it. But yeah, that thing was $1,100. And I haven't told my mom yet that it's missing. Because like I said, I don't want the laws involved in this. mom's car down here. It's kind of rough. Show you his house, so I'm gonna show you his gate. When I was coming back to get it, he locked that gate. I know he did. He locked it, and so I couldn't come back and get my iPad. But it was right there recording, right here, somewhere off in here. And now it's gone. Let me get out. Around, see if there's any tools. I know it's before I passed that bridge and he took it. I don't want to get the laws involved in this, but I might have to. I had it somewhere off in here. As you can see, nothing is here. Took everything with him. Pretty sorry, especially when you know the person. And he knows I seen him took it. Content. Drop a like on this video if you enjoyed it. Keep it real. Always remember, Jesus loves you.